Hello, my name is David Dolnick from Viavi Solutions. Today we're going to focus on channel check on the ONX meter. Previously we looked at the OneCheck application, which is a one-time snapshot of all the downstream services as well as the upstream services utilizing the DOCSIS ranging test. Today we're going to focus on channel check and we'll go through the live measurement now. So I will select channel check. And just like in the OneCheck application, we do have the capability of either making the OneCheck or channel check measurement at the tap, the ground block, or the customer CPE device, meaning behind the set-top box, cable modem, MTA, or DTA device. In this particular instance, we've already selected the CPE equipment, and I am connected to test port number 1. Previously, we built a work order that we utilize for the OneCheck application. We can continue to use that work order, or what we'll do now is we'll touch on the work order tab over here, which will bring up a screen allowing me to add a new work order. Again, it will default to the current date and timestamp, and I will hit the back arrow key over here to wipe out that field and put in our account information, and now we'll hit enter. Now we have our new work order number and the view results screen disappears. And I will simply hit the start button over here to start the application. So very quickly it initializes the measurement engine. Now it's going to search through the spectrum to identify the physical layer of all the different channels over there. And we see the dots there indicating it's already found the channel plan. Now as these dots disappear, it's making the physical layer measurements across all those individual channels. And very quickly, we can see once again that we have one of the channels being displayed in red, which would be our channel from yesterday, or probably our channel 95. But right now we're looking at, in particular, channel 87. And the reason why it's displaying 87 is when we last looked at the OneCheck mode, that was the previous channel that was being viewed or tested. Now, again, the difference between OneCheck and channel check is that this is a real-time measurement, meaning we update all the screen feature displays here every 1 second in time. So if there's a change in level greater than 1/10 of a dB, as we just see here, flipping from minus 0.4 to minus 0.5, we're seeing minor fluctuations in the channel level. Our MER appears to be rock solid at 39.3 dB. Pre and post look excellent. Our echoes or reflections are greater than 25 dB down at minus 37, looking very good. Group delay well below our 200 nanosecond maximum, and the in-channel frequency response well below our 2 dB maximum at 9/10 of 1 dB. DQI, or Digital Quality Index, is indicating that there are no errors in the bitstream whatsoever. Not one per billion, but absolutely zero errors in the bitstream currently. As we page up, we will see some of the adjacent channels. Again, since I'm on channel 87, we see the lower adjacent channels, and then we see the upper adjacent channels. And what we're showing is a relative level as well as their MER, or their noise floor. One thing interesting about the ONX meter is that we will also display ingress underneath the actual channel itself, and not just channel 87 that we're looking at in the center here, but again, the lower adjacent and the upper adjacent channels. Previously in the DSAM meter, we have a measurement called QAM ingress, which would allow me to see this noise floor under one individual channel. But certainly if I'm looking at this list of adjacent channels and I see diminished MER on any of these channels, I may see the adjacent noise floor raised up on that particular channel. And certainly if I see some spiking like I see underneath a couple of these channels over here, then if the spike is at a high enough level, that would be ingress underneath the channel, which of course would diminish my MER number. Our MER numbers are within a few tenths of a dB of each other, and we can see here the noise floor appears to be relatively flat across all the adjacent channels. Looking further over time over here, we're looking at level over time of this channel 87. We see that it's not drifted by more than 1/10 of a dB, a max of 0.4, a min of 0.5, and live measurement currently bouncing between 0.4 and 0.5, that 1/10 of a dB difference. MER over time is showing us on this particular channel, that our current MER is at 39.3, but we've dropped down by 0.4 of a dB to 38.9. Again, not a major change in the noise floor there. Looking at bit error rate over time, we're at a perfect 1.0e to the minus 9th for a real-time pre- and post-measurement. And we've not ever fallen below that. You can see our worst case measurements are also 1.0e to the minus 9th for both pre and post bit error rate. As I look at DQI, it looks like we've been maintaining a perfect 10. We've never dropped below that. And now we can actually see the actual in-band response or in-channel frequency response across this channel 87. So we're seeing 9/10 of a dB difference, which is probably the difference between the peak of the carrier over here and the beginning of the channel. There's approximately 9/10 of a dB difference that it's seeing between high and low across the top part of that 6 megahertz QAM haystack. As I page further up, I see now my tilt measurements in 10 dB per division scale, and a direct correlation of that is the smart scan, although in 1 dB per division scale. So it certainly looks a lot more jagged than the tilt measurement, but again, that's because we're looking at a much higher resolution. Instead of 10 dB per division, we're at 1 dB per division, so considerably greater resolution, so we're seeing much more jagged response on the top parts of the carriers, but this is absolutely a representation of what I see here across the bar graph display for my tilt display. If we come down over here, we see some of our favorite channels. We added 87 yesterday. And as we go further down the list over here, we see the constellation pattern display for this channel 87. So again, the big difference between the one check mode and the channel check mode is that we're always updating the channel information for every channel that we view in the screen when we look at the channel check mode. When we look at one check, it's just a one-time snapshot of what we see for the physical layer measurements of each individual channel. So we also display level, MER, pre and post bit error rate. We don't display DQI because it's not a real-time live measurement. And remember, DQI is a measurement of errors in the pre-bit stream only. But we update that every 1 second in time, so we must be tied to a live network in order to be able to see that DQI number. So since this is a live measurement as compared to one check, we show you the box for the DQI number as well. Just like in one check, we certainly have the capability of scanning across the different channels in the list over here or touching on the spectrum to another part of the spectrum to analyze alternate channels. As I mentioned before, the network that we are tied to has a combination of both analog and digital channels. So if I want to move back into the analog world, or digital world rather, I just simply touch above one of the digital QAM channels here. It takes a few seconds to acquire the DQI number, and then we see our live measurements taking place, and again, updating every 1 second in time. So a combination of being able to measure analog and digital channels, updating real time every 1 second in time. So if I come back here, we've now completed our measurement here for this channel. We can certainly save off this channel plan if we want to utilize it further in the network or to compare from one location to another, such as making a measurement outside of the subscriber's home at the tap and then measuring inside the house. If we have a channel trap that's taking out a channel behind a wall plate, that would be identified by the channel missing in the channel plan. So we do have the availability to save off the channel plan. This was also available in the one check mode. So that is a review of the channel check application for the ONX meter. Thank you once again. We'll return with more applications such as ingress scan, DOCSIS check, the RF quick check, and the spectrum mode. Once again, this is David from the Obvious Solutions, and I thank you for your time. Have a wonderful day.